Hello, Patrick Walchuk here, standing in front of our newest listing, a really unique and interesting property that promises a lot of development potential or to purchase as is. So where we are right now is at 3653 Albion Road. Now, it's a modest three-bedroom, one-bathroom bungalow, and it's got an attached garage. Now, this is being offered as an estate sale, so buyers must do their own due diligence, and the seller and the listing agent make no representation or warranties of any nature whatsoever. The property is being sold as is where is. Now, the house itself is perfectly livable, although admittedly it needs updates and renovating. So it is located just a 1 minute car ride or a 6 or 7 minute walk from Bank Street that way. So you're really close to all the amenities that you would need. It's also near lots of public transit, both on the street here, including the O-Train, which is nearby, and the new LRT Southern Extension. So it's just great for public transit. Now, when this area was built in the 1950s and 60s, the homes were on well and septic, so they have very, very large lots. This lot here is 75 feet across, 210 feet deep. It's an irregular lot, and it's the total lot size is 14,510 feet. 14,510 feet. It's massive. So let's go take a look at the backyard, and I want to show you that before we go inside the house. Hello, so now we're at the back of the property. The cameraman's actually almost up against the back of the house, and I want to stand at the back here to show you just how large it is. Now, this lot is zoned R2, and there's a strip of land at the back that is zoned R3, and it runs probably roughly right along here. So I'm in the R3 zone. Now, what you can do here under R2 zoning is to build two semi-detached properties, and you could put a secondary dwelling unit in the basement for each one, and in effect you end up with four properties. That's under current zoning. Now, under the new zoning that is proposed to come into effect near the end of 2025, this lot is scheduled to be N2 and N3. Based upon the size of this lot, N2 will permit a 20-unit building. Now, that is subject to height restrictions and setbacks, of course. And N2 allows 150 units per hectare. That's what the N2 means. Now, if you're a developer, you can think about land banking this property. You can put a tenant in place until the new zoning comes into effect and until your permits are ready, and you can take advantage of this new possible opportunity. The vacant parcel of land beside me, it's right here. This was purchased. The owner has minor variances done on the property, and now it's been subdivided into six building lots with 25-foot frontages. Again, the 25-foot front, and they're about 170 feet deep. Again, this lot, 75-foot frontage and 210 feet deep, okay? So hello again. I wanted to show you the property from a different angle. So the photographer's now at the back of the building where I was, and I wanted to show you the back here because we can talk about alternate uses, and one of them is that you could buy this house and renovate it, or buy it and renovate it as you live in it, because it is perfectly habitable. Or if you're looking to turn part or all of it into an income property, you can put an SDU in the basement, and that's why I'm here. This door on my left, if you go in there, you turn immediately to your right and you're in the kitchen, or you go straight ahead and it goes down into the basement. So it's got the layout that would allow a basement apartment to be constructed very, very easily, and SDUs are permitted in all neighborhoods in Ottawa except Rockcliffe. So that's it. Come on with me and I'll take you on a tour of the inside of the house. Okay, so let's take a tour of our Albion Road bungalow. Obviously the front door that I just came through here. Got a little foyer area and bigger foyer area here, which is quite nice. Now, We're going into the living room, dining room area, which is, you know, fairly spacious for a bungalow of this era. But full disclosure here, I've been made aware that the hardwood flooring under this wall-to-wall carpeting has been screwed into the subfloor. So if anybody were take up this to do renovations, you'd either have to tear up the hardwood or put something like vinyl plank over top of it. So anyhow, this is the living area. Dining area, as you can see, with a light fixture, and we left this table here to better define that. And coming this way is the kitchen. And again, this house was built in about 1960, and the owner had renovated it approximately, this to me looks like around 1985. Cameraman's just gonna take his time and give you a slow pan to take a look at things. Okay, and as you notice, it had a nice big window. It's a very bright kitchen. We've got the blinds closed for better photography, but there's a nice view of that large backyard that you saw earlier. So remember, I was talking about the secondary dwelling unit. This is the back door to the exterior. This is the door to the basement. We'll show you later. So all you need to do is put a wall up here, put a wall up here, and you've got direct access to go directly into the basement, and you can probably create a three-bedroom apartment down in that basement. So come on along here, and we will show you what is, I would consider this to be the third bedroom, although again, it needs a door where I just walked through, but it is, you know, average size bedroom, and there was a basically a permanent built-in armoire put in there because it didn't have a closet. And coming out here, this is where we started our tour. We're in the foyer at the front. And as the cameraman comes by, he'll just show you the four-piece bathroom. And by the way, in our language, a four-piece is a shower, a tub, a sink, and a toilet. And next, he'll take you into the primary bedroom. Not a bad view when you wake up in the morning here, looking out that window at that backyard, eh? And then coming out here, back into the foyer, and you can see the third and final bedroom. And next we'll go down into the basement. All right, so we'll finish off our tour here in the basement, obviously unfinished. I want to let you know that the dimensions are roughly 40 feet long, 20 feet wide. They're actually a little bit larger than that. And you got a lot of possibilities down here, and that's why I want to show this to you, the large size of the basement. Now here, if you come view the property and you're wondering why this has a patch in the concrete floor, again, you may recall I said that this was on well and septic when it was originally built. And so when municipal services were brought in, the water lines here, the drains are here, so this was dug out to put in municipal services, so that's a good thing. So continue to come along with me down here. And there's something else I just want to really quickly show you. You'll see that blue tank and an old pump in the corner. Again, that's from the well and the pump for the well back in the day. They're no longer being used. Over here is, you know, the typical cold cellar in a house, and you know, these people used it for storage and a wine cellar, that kind of thing. And over here, fairly normal basement. You've got a couple of appliances here, and this is a sump pit, and it's no longer functioning. Again, that was when there was septic in the backyard, but they're not on that anymore, so I just wanted to point that out. The only other thing I can say is that all the appliances in this house are included. They're purchased as is, where is as well, so there's no warranties, but they're supposed to be all working, except we're unsure about the fridge in the basement here. And by the way, quickly I'll show you, and cameraman, watch your head, a stove here. This was installed 20, 25 years ago, only used a couple of times. But anyhow, you can also see the great space here, and this would probably fit a 3-bedroom basement apartment. Okay, so now I'd just like to summarize the possible uses of this property, both if somebody were to buy it and live in it. So let's go through it. So quickly, number one, buy the house, use it as is. Again, perfectly livable house. You saw what it looks like. It's in need of updating, renovating. Number two, you could tear it down and build your large forever house on this massive lot. And if you go up and down Albion Road, you can see that some people have done that. So that's a great location for a huge house. Number three, you could renovate it and add a secondary dwelling unit to the basement. And number four, you could tear it down, build a maximum number of units under R zoning or N zoning, and we discussed that you could possibly get 4 under R, and you might be able to get up to 10 or more under the N zoning, and that's anticipated to fall into place about the third or fourth quarter of next year. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to give me a call. Patrick Walchuk, and thank you for watching.